Boss, this contract comes out of Angola. That's right, Central Africa, where Emmerich claimed they were working on a weapon to surpass Metal Gear. There's been a massive oil spill from Mafinda oil field. It's flowing into the river and contaminating the water supply. An environmental NGO has asked us to stop the spill by destroying the facility. Environmental activism isn't exactly our line of work, but it's not that simple either. The group operating the oil facility and causing the spill is the rebel group UNITA. And word has it that UNITA is getting supplied with U.S. military weapons. That sounds to me like Cypher's pulling their strings. Boss, it's time to give Cypher a little surprise.
Interesting, what is it? Let me change the time.
Angola's Mfinda oil field, upstream from the landing point. A spill has covered the whole area in crude. A pipeline that crosses the Muneni River failed, and now the shore's a mess. Not to mention the villages downstream have no drinking water. To the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mfinda oil field was outdated. Abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the broker's a front company, Cypher's. Keeping tabs on UNITA could tell us who's pulling its strings. Exploitation, tribal clashes. What's big business for developed countries? You've arrived at Masa Village. It's been turned into a supply hub for UNITA, meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources. Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands.
Squamanda!
Alles geht schnell, das seht ihr. Was wollt ihr denn da? Alle Geräte verskern wir auf Position.
The PF soldiers are speaking Afrikaans, an official language of the Republic of South Africa. Boss, we're gonna need someone with the Afrikaans interpreter skill to move.
waste it.
Resources. Sander drills oil wells wherever they can throughout that region. And when the oil dries up, they abandon the facility. Then it's only a matter of time before the aging equipment starts leaking crude. That means Unita's takeover is the perfect cover for Sander. Now they can blame the spill on a bunch of oil thieves. However you look at it, Sander's far from squeaky clean. Transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. The details are on your iDroid. That's the oily water separator tank, one of the targets. Take it out.
Delta 6, fired by the SAG. Zoek now, oil. Recepteer, begrijp. Wees op jullie hoede. nächste Leitung hören, die umbringen mich. Echt? HK, HK, das ist hier. Und wenn ich fest ausgedrückt mal Kontakt verloren nach Kreisfühl, dann kann noch immer so weit wegkriegen. Ein Passier, wachs an mich. Hör.
Time doesn't stop while you use the iDroid. You can even move around while using it, but pay attention to your surroundings. Rain. Sound of rainfall should help to mask your footsteps.
Huh.
Facility and stop the flow of oil. To prevent the machinery being turned back on again, you need to turn off the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. Check the details on your iDroid. There's the transfer pump control room. The emergency stop button is probably inside it. Transfer pump shutoff confirmed. Next, destroy the oily water separator tank. That'll ensure they can never use the facility again.
Clean now. Thought it was impossible, but it's raining. So
what is the situation? Are the engineer stand by?
Separator tank. You'll need to use explosives. Once it goes up, the enemy will come running. Secure the area before you detonate the C4. The remaining target is in the oily water separator tank. Destroy it.
Oh.
this. I didn't get rid of everyone, but I got rid of most of them. So I'm hoping I can just run away now.
Out of the hot zone, by chopper or by land. It's your choice.
Yeah.
Whoa, whoa. Oh, sorry. That was your fault, alright. Incredible. Oh, look at that. The circle's nearly filled. Oh my god.
Facility all the while pretending they were the victims. One other thing. Sanger's Johannesburg head office is just a room in a multi-tenant building. Company's essentially non-existent. 3 years ago, that investment fund stepped in and started gutting it through a series of mergers and sell-offs, and get this, the fund itself no longer exists either. It's a shell corporation, meaning someone is just using Sanger's name from the shadows. But what about those strange corpses? Just what the hell were they doing over there?
Questioning Huey. The Walker armament.
Hey!
Wow.
Snake! I've customized a Walker gear just for you. It features a silent running system, great for infiltration missions. And you can also summon it to your location. I've taken the liberty of calling it the D-Walker. It's armed with a suppressed tranquilizer gun. If you want to add other weaponry or upgrade the chassis, give the order from your iDroid.
A. Two A's and a C. That's good. That one guy had an absurd medical thing, so... Tis good. Tis very good, very good.
Boss, I've updated the mission list. We've received a new job offer. It doesn't seem connected to Cypher or Skullface at all, But if it goes well, we may get an Afrikaans interpreter. The details are on your iDroid.
I'm interested.
Snake! You finally came. Just... don't record this, okay?
I'm not recording anything. What's this about?
What I'm about to say stays between you and me. It's about the weapon to surpass Metal Gear. Do you know a researcher by the name of Clark? He works in the biotech industry. Real advanced stuff. His area is bioengineering. But lately, he's also gotten into genetic research.
Never heard of him.
Well then, what do you know about cloning?
I think I've heard enough.
Hold on, this is important. Cloning lets you create a genetic copy of an organism. You take the nucleus.
Okay, I'll just have to listen to that later, I guess. Lingua Franca. França. Whatever.
Several high-level British CFA officials are being held by their Afrikaner colleagues. One of these prisoners is the rescue target, a guy known as the Viscount. The target's location is unknown, but they're bound to have an interpreter present when they interrogate him. We've used info from the intel unit to predict the interpreter's location. It's on your iDroid. Follow the interpreter and extract the target when you find him.
Came. Just don't record this, okay?
I'm not recording anything. What's this about?
What I'm about to say stays between you and me. It's about the weapon to surpass Metal Gear. Do you know a researcher by the name of Clark? He works in the biotech industry. Real advanced stuff. His area is bioengineering. But lately, he's also gotten into genetic research.
Never heard of him.
Well then, what do you know about cloning?
You found the interpreter. Now follow him to the target.
Hold on, this is important. Cloning lets you create a genetic copy of an organism. You take the nucleus of one of its cells, and you swap it with the nucleus of an unfertilized egg from another member of the same species. They started out working with plants, but since then they've had success with other organisms, including mammals. It's a hot area for a lot of places right now. Corporations, universities, research groups. There's no shortage of scientists out to get famous and patent their work, with morality taking a back seat.
Isn't that a little outside your field?
It's got nothing to do with my research. But I thought it might be of interest to you. Cloning, and Dr. Clark, I mean.
Go on.
Now, this is really highly classified stuff. But I've heard that an American biotech company has successfully cloned a human being. What's more, it happened over 10 years...
The CFA are all business. Hard to believe they're interrogating their own. Situation must be worse than we thought. Make a wrong move, and they could kill the target without warning.
Even to others in his field, his age, where he comes from, that might not be his real name. And I can't even say for sure he's a he. Clark's employer, ATGC, its company motto is embracing your hopes, preserving talent.
Afrikaans is the lingua franca for mercs in that area. If you're going to get any information from interrogations, you'll need an interpreter. Don't extract the interpreter just yet. If he doesn't turn up, they won't be able to do the interrogation. If they then decide the target's no longer any use to them, They won't hesitate to kill him.
I know. Stop talking to me.
DARPA
is the war.
A driving force behind human cloning. It's a pretty high priority project for them. And this Dr. Clark, some say he's a pivotal player in Cypher. But that's not all. Every cell nucleus in an organism contains the genetic information for that organism. Think of it as a blueprint for life. Clark appears to be working on how to decode this information and rearrange it at will. If you could do that, it would mean being able to custom design human beings for specific purposes. Can you believe that? Suppose for a moment that this is all fact. A man of your talents, if your genetic information died with you, that would be a terrible loss for mankind. But what if mankind could preserve you for future generations by cloning you?
All right, enough. I get the idea.
Look, I know it's inductive reasoning, but this weapon to surpass Metal Gear they're developing in Africa, I believe it's something that uses this new technology. Speaking as a fellow scientist, it chills me to the bone.
That's rich coming from you.
If genes serve as our blueprint, then I wonder if they include an impulse that drives us to tweak the design. Can you imagine that? Genes, encoded with information that wants its children to decode it. Is life itself putting the direction of our next evolution in the hands of scientists? I guess it would take some real arrogance to believe that. And yet, it could be what Cypher's after.
I think you're barking up the wrong tree. But that was an interesting story.
If you're going to... That's not the target. Orders are only the Viscount gets rescued. Can't understand why he'd receive special treatment. But I don't imagine it'll be a problem to save the other prisoners too.
Right.
Wait a minute. Look, I want to help you. I want to be of service here. I'm risking my life with this.
Is that so? Maybe it's time we brought someone else into the conversation.
No, not him. Not Ocelot. You can't do this.
Doesn't show up, they won't be able to interrogate anyone. Then they'll just kill the target. careful not to draw the enemy's attention.
Something.
Boss, one of the prisoners has been killed. We don't know if it was a target or not. Hurry up and ID the target. Mission complete. Great work.
B for Big Chungus. Oh, look at that. That's a big number.
Prisoners filled us in about the Viscount. It turns out he's a real two-faced son of a bitch. He was planning to secure the MPLA's oil field rights for himself in exchange for swapping the CFA's alliance from the anti-government Uniter rebels to the state-backed MPLA. He hid this from the Afrikaners, but once he thought the jig was up, he tried to pin it on the other British personnel and take off. The Afrikaners captured him, and that was when he asked us to rescue him, and only him. I'll throw him in the brig for now, but we may have to be extra persuasive with this one. By the way, boss, we got some interesting news out of our friend the Viscount. He mentioned that more than a few PFs in the region have purchased Walker gears. The CFA's the same. That's Soviet Army technology. and it's still a prototype. Only Cypher could be leaking it to the PFs. But the question is, why?
Yep, raving mongoose, laughing wallaby. Oh, it's a lot of A's.
When Quiet first came here, she demonstrated her marksmanship against that enemy fighter plane. It showed she was much more than your everyday crack shot. Hitting a moving target from 600 meters is a challenge, but it's possible with the right training and equipment. But shooting down that missile, that's a world apart from taking out a soldier on patrol. The chopper and the missile were in motion, meaning different vectors at high velocity in three-dimensional space, and she shot an unguided bullet that had to fight air resistance and gravity. All that while the chopper was taking evasive maneuvers. Some of the best target leading I've ever known. She has a superhuman sense of spatial awareness. You put her in a fighter jet, and she'd be an ace right off the bat. Hell, your judgment was top class, too. Realizing she could take out that pilot, that's quick thinking. You and Quiet could make a hell of a team. You'd be damn near unstoppable. Quiet is still in her cell. Only a few staff are authorized to go near her. She hasn't tried anything funny, but that's what bothers me most.
In particular?
What does she have to gain by coming to Mother Base? I first thought she was under orders from Cypher to take you out. She didn't manage it in Afghanistan, so round two happens here. So I lighten the guard. And that lock on her door is a joke.
You gave her an opening. And?
Well, she hasn't killed you yet. And I hate to say it, but she's had plenty of chances.
You made me the bait.
Poisonous bait. What better? Anyway, she didn't bite. Quiet is keeping her silence. So I'm left with no idea again what she's doing here. We tried communicating with her through writing. That didn't work either. Whether she's illiterate, dyslexic, or just plain stubborn, she won't cooperate. I just don't get it. If she tried to contact the outside, it'd be picked up by our counterintelligence net. But it's clean. There's no sign she's had contact with the staff. Base facilities, nothing. She's almost got the men wanting her to try something, just to find out what she's up to. And she's in there putting on the failed soldier look, all downcast eyes and defeated sighs. But she doesn't kill herself. She can't be trying to leave Cypher and surrender to us.
So what's the verdict?
This may sound optimistic, but here's how I see it. Quiet came here to fulfill some objective. To kill you, maybe to destroy Diamond Dogs. Whatever it was, before she could do it, something changed her mind. Yes. When I look at her, I sense hesitation.
You think she'd betray Cypher?
Can't say for sure. I prefer the ones that talk. Anyway, we'll keep her under watch. And we're also looking into those special abilities of hers. You'll be the first to know if something comes up. Why not look in on her yourself once in a while?
Right.
You called that thing Sahelanthropus. Where does the name come from?
Well, several years ago, an excavation team discovered a hominid skull in the Sahel region.
Central Africa. The Southern Sahara.
Cypher gave the specimen the name Sahelanthropus, Man of Sahel. And then they covered the whole thing up.
Why?
They probably wanted to monopolize information about human evolution to have a head start in their genetic research. At least, until they had an idea of what they'd found.
It was that big of a discovery, huh?
Sahelanthropus was a gracile hominid, estimated to have lived about 7 million years ago. What's significant about it is how its skull's foramen magnum faces down, In other words, its spinal column supported its head from underneath.
It stood upright.
Right. Which would mean Sahelanthropus walked upright 3 million years before Australopithecus, making it the world's oldest human species.
Walking upright. I get it. Hence the name Sahelanthropus for your machine.
Walking upright was the decisive difference between our ancestors and other anthropoids. Our brains could get heavier once they were supported by the spinal column. That led to the use of tools and the development of complex communication through language. Only man is capable of this. My creation will be the progenitor of all bipedal weapon platforms.
And you did this for Cypher?
No, not at all. Sahelanthropus is the best proof that I never betrayed you guys.
What do you mean?
The reconstructed Sahelanthropus skull looked exactly like the skull we used as our logo 9 years ago in the Caribbean.
An army without a nation. Outside the world order.
The design was based on Pangaea, the supercontinent that existed 250 million years ago, right?
Yeah. When the world was a single landmass, that concept's at the source of our strength.
I felt the same way about Sahelanthropus. Sure, I was forced to build it under their orders, but I always wanted to put its technology back in our hands someday. That's the reason I incorporated the old insignia into Sahelanthropus's name. Don't you see? That's how much I was thinking about you guys.
Oh, I see, all right. I see someone desperate to cover his ass. You can say whatever you want after the fact. But that skull also symbolizes somebody else. Skull Face.
Snake, you finally came. Just... don't...
There's a violent power struggle going on within the Contract Forces of Africa, the PF that ran security for the Mfinda oil field. Most of their key people are Afrikaners, but naturally for a South African organization, some of its founders are British. Details are sketchy, but apparently the Afrikaners are holding these British personnel for interrogation near Kaziba camp. We've been asked to rescue one of them, a man known as the Viscount. We don't have the Viscount's exact location, but he doesn't speak the Afrikaners' language, Afrikaans. They'll need an interpreter who speaks English in order to interrogate him. Meaning if we tail the interpreter, he'll lead us right to the target. By the way, the contract specifies that it's all right to ignore the other British prisoners. But the final decision is yours, boss.
Hard to believe how many of those bipedal weapons have popped up around Africa. When did that start? No more than 6 months ago. Didn't really hit me until I came here.
They're not supposed to be in use yet. Emmerich says they were still doing the last round of fine-tuning.
The doctor has no idea. His research has already hit the black market. Both sides of the Iron Curtain will have it by now. Even so, they're spreading much too fast. Sure, the Walker gears can operate in any terrain. Their mobility's just as good in the jungle as it is in the desert. That would come in handy in a place like Africa. They are modules that can one day be used as nuclear weapon systems. And with that in mind, the numbers are way too large. There must be another reason they're so widespread.
Like what?
It's all about needs. To small-time outfits like most of these private forces, this product is a dream come true. Hell, it goes beyond PS. This is the ultimate weapon, the forbidden fruit, for anyone with an enemy to fight and people to defend.
A nuclear deterrent.
Exactly. Sounds familiar, huh? PFs are all operating off your playbook. You created these times. But could this be the new weapon in Africa that Emmerich talked about? If it is, why is Cypher letting everyone and his brother get their hands on one? What comes next? Selling new
weapons
in the open? Making them public property?
Why don't they give that a try? Then the next war really will be fought with sticks.
Right. The man we're dealing with isn't foolish enough to make a suicide pact with the world.
So, what is Cypher really up to?
dangerous.
Departing!